Well, good morning, everybody. I hope you're enjoying the beginning of week six. And of course, today we have had photos taken. I'm sure many of you look fantastic as we took those happy snaps. And it was great to see lots of photos. Now, there's an old photo now, a few weeks old, and we were there at Book Week. But now, proper class photos, looking forward to seeing them. So that's a wonderful opportunity. What? Hang on, what is this? What have we got here? Not sure. Maggie the Magpie.
Hey, Mr. Magpie, how you doing?
He's looking pretty careful. He's looking, oh, running away. What's he doing?
He doesn't like being watched.
No, doesn't like it at all, Mr. Maggie. Come on, Mr. Maggie, stay for a photo. Oh, I'm not sure what's going on there. There he is again, over by my car. See if we can chase him. And he's running away, he's trying to escape the old Maggie. Okay. Oh, speaking of running. I know a bunch of young people at ACC Hume who have been running for weeks, Mondays, Wednesdays, Fridays, and running to earn money for tomorrow today, that very important group here in Benalla who help families when they need help. Tomorrow today. So look, this is our last week for running. So make sure you do plenty of laps, get those ticks done so that you can start collecting your money. You know how much you'll be earning. You can bring that money into school next week. So running is important to us here at school. So look at these two champions, big smile on their faces. Looks like they've been running for a long way and they've still got plenty of petrol in the tank. And the money, bring that money in and we'll be able to give it to tomorrow today. So check with your sponsors, your relatives, whoever has said that they will sponsor you for your running, need to go and get that money this week and bring it in next week. So, oh, here's Maggie again. Maggie's running as well. Oh, look at that, Maggie go. I hope that Maggie's earning lots of money for tomorrow today. Here he is. There he is again. Quick, get him. Go, go,
Mr.
go.
Magpie, you won't stop for talk.
No, no. Oh, he's running well too. I hope you finish this week's running really well. Anyway, we've got our final week memorizing the last section of the Ten Commandments. It's obviously from Genesis chapter 20, verses 13 to 17, the Ten Commandments, and we're looking at the second five of the Ten Commandments. And so here they are. Let's say them all together. One, two. Exodus chapter 20, verses 13 to 17. Do not kill people. Respect marriage promises. Do not steal. Do not lie. Do not be jealous of what other people have. Really important. A straight message from God. These things are issues that he tells us so that we can live well together with other people. Remember, there's that picture of Mount Sinai where Moses went up, and there's a picture of Moses delivering the Ten Commandments. So let's have a look at what these Ten Commandments mean. Do not kill. Another way of saying it to you in school is do not kill people. Well, it's better to say, look after people. Look after people. Keep your promises. Important. Keep your promises. Respect other people's things. That's another way of speaking about not stealing. And the last two that we haven't looked at carefully yet, commandment number nine, tell the truth or do not lie. And the last one, which says, do not covet, it really means be Be content with what you have. Don't worry about what others have, or don't wish for and be jealous of what other people have. Very, very important. So let's just review. The do not kill was, we said, look after each other last week. Look after each other. Keep your promises. And then do not steal means other people have the right to own property. This guy, he has the right to own his bike, his helmet. And so it's important to just look after your property, look after other people's property, and let them have their things. Don't take other people's things. Now we'll move on to the last two commandments. The first one is pretty easy to understand. Just tell the truth. You know, sometimes when a teacher might ask you, you've done the wrong thing, the teacher might ask you, and you're tempted to tell a lie. Oh, it wasn't me, miss. Or mum or dad ask you, well, did you do that? Look, just relax, be calm, and just tell the truth. It's always better to tell the truth. That means just to be honest. Honesty is the best policy. In fact, honesty is the only policy, to tell the truth. So that's commandment number 9. Finally, looking at commandment number 10, which is you shall not covet. Do not covet. Covet other people's things. Covet means to really, really want something that someone else has. Look at these two dogs. This big fella over here, he's just got that small bone, and he's looking over at his little mate who's got this whopper of a bone, and he's saying to himself, oh, I think I would like to have his bone. Well, that's what coveting's like. Poor old big dog. But big dog can go and get his own bone. And little dog, well, I think he's pretty happy with what he's got. Here's another example where one girl's got more money than the other girl. And the other girl with the little bit of money, what's going through her mind? Do you think she might be coveting and saying, oh, I want her money. I don't want just a little bit. I want all of that she's got. That's what coveting's all about. And God says, don't be like that. Don't covet. Oh, this guy here over on this side, he has a small piece of cake, and he, look at his brain going hot, hot like a fire, and he's going, I want that guy's big piece of cake. That's what coveting is all about. And the Bible says, you shall not covet your neighbor's goods. And the final example, oh, look at these two. She won the trophy and he missed out, and he's coveting. Oh, he's even biting his thumbnail. He's so upset, and he's got it in his mind. I should have that trophy. I should have won. That's what coveting is. So God says, be content with what you've got. Don't be upset or be really angry and want what other people have. Do not covet. So, as we've been saying the last two other weeks, God's gift to us is the Ten Commandments. This is how we can live well. We can be loving out with other people. We can thrive in life. We can shine like a light. We can be loving up to God and loving out to people. The Ten Commandments help us to do this, and to be just thriving in life like these young people. So that's what we're really on about when we talk about the Ten Commandments. Now, here's our song. Let's sing along together. All about the perfect ten. Let's sing it up. This is our last week on this song.
Number one, we've just begun. God should be first in your life. Number two is the idol rule, those graven images are Christ. Number three, God's name should be never spoken in jest. Number four, the Sabbath's for our worship and for rest. Number five, we all should strive.
Good singing, everybody. Fantastic. The perfect 10. Well, this is your last week to memorize those last five, and they're so important. They help us to learn how to live with other people, loving out, as we keep saying. So I hope you enjoyed that song. And it's all about thriving. Doesn't matter how old you are, whether you're teenagers, year five, year six, whether you're younger, doesn't matter. Whether you're older, doesn't matter. Learning to thrive and to live well by going God's way, the perfect 10. Oh, look at this little champion. Isn't she just enjoying life? And that's what living the perfect 10 can help us to do. Okay, well, there, we're just so glad God gave Moses the perfect 10, the 10 commandments. There's a picture of not really Moses, but an actor who was playing the part of Moses in a very famous movie called The Ten Commandments. You know, there was even a movie made about The Ten Commandments, and that's Charlton Heston, the actor playing the role of Moses in that movie. So, the perfect 10 that teaches us how to love God, loving up, and love people, loving out. It's great that you young people are learning the perfect 10. God bless. Have a great week. Bye for now.